Okay, welcome to Checking In With, presented by O'Neill. We are with Twisted Tea, HEP, Suzuki Racing's Freddie Noren, Fast Freddie, back in yellow. How does it feel?
Yeah, it feels really good. I really like the bike. I like the crew. Obviously, I've had some time on the Suzuki previously. Actually, I spent a lot of time on Suzuki back home in Sweden when I raced amateur racing and when I was a pro back home in Sweden. So I feel right at home. This bike's feeling really good. And obviously, I don't have a ton of time on this bike right now. I have about four rides. Today will be the fifth and then come racing Saturday. But I'm really excited. The bike feels good, like I said, and then the guys are awesome. So I'm really stoked to be here. I think it's going to be a good year. I'm expecting it to be my best for outdoor season of my career, so that's what I'm aiming for.
Okay, so you've ridden for this team previously. How different is the bike now from then?
So, yeah, I did World Supercross for them this fall, so obviously the bike is different from that alone, just being Supercross to motocross. So, I like the bike this fall. They've done some improvements since then as well. If I would have done some outdoor riding back then, I could have a better back-to-back comparison, I guess, if you want to put it that way. But motor's amazing, chassis handles awesome, good suspension. So, overall, like, it's hard to pinpoint what's so much different from the fall to now, since I didn't do any type of outdoor riding that fall, but it's a good bike.
So I think you, by all accounts, you had a really good Supercross season, some good showings. What is it like coming off of that on a completely different motorcycle and switching over?
Yeah, so it was my best 450 Supercross season of my career. So obviously I'm happy about that. As a racer, you always want it to be better, and I think it could have and should have been better. But overall, I'm happy with how things went. I raced 17 rounds, I'm healthy and all that. And then transitioning into this now with these guys has been very easy. Like I said, the bike was really good right off the bat. I haven't needed to do like a lot of adjusting, to put it that way. Yeah, it's a very good team. Obviously, Kenny had a win on the bike and podiums, and Chisholm and Shane has been riding awesome as well. So it's a proven concept, I guess, to put it that way. So yeah, I'm just looking forward to it.
Okay, so you're switching bikes, but you're also switching gear because of some contracts and stuff. Is that just kind of like a whatever thing, or is there some a period of adaptation for riders?
Yeah, like you said, there is different sponsors on different teams, so you'll have to change. Like now, I'm changing gear. Going from one brand to Fly. I do really like Fly, so it's same there. It's been very easy, and they've been good. They send me, you know, a bunch of stuff that I could try first and get comfortable in, and then once they get that figured out, it's easy for them to, you know, kind of know what I like. But same there, and they make good gear, so it's kind of like, here's some gear, try it out, see what you like, and it felt good right off the bat. Keeping my AlphaStar boots, so that makes it easy as well. My EVS knee braces or pads, I actually run the pads, so that's not too bad. But yeah, there's a little bit of adjusting, you know. Fitment is a little different, but overall it's been super easy, so I'm pumped on that.
Okay, when we were in the press conference and I heard you speaking up there, I was like, I turned around, I was like, oh, that's Freddie talking. And I thought about it. How long have you been here, and have you noticed that you've completely lost your accent?
Yeah, I've been here a while now. I pretty much feel like an American. I don't have a citizenship yet, though I will apply for it pretty soon. I have a green card, but I've been here full-time since 2014. My first season I did was 2011. I did outdoors. I could only stay here for about 6 months back then. So I did that from 11 till 14. But yeah, I've been here a long time, and it's been an awesome journey. So pumped to be here. My wife's from Ohio, so she's an American, and we have two kids now as well. So I'm sure I'll be here for the rest of my life.
Okay, last question. Man, I've heard it before, but hearing it again in the press conference, the money that is available for the Supercross series, got super duper motocross, but I mean, that's got to be exciting for a guy like you.
Yeah, no, for sure. You know, this is my job, and you know, it pays the bill and whatnot, but it's not like I'll make a ton of money, to put it that way. So when there's opportunities to make more money, you know, it's good for me as a racer. And I hadn't heard anything about the super motocross playoff rounds as far as a purse and all that. So it certainly, you know, gets you a little bit motivated sometimes when you put some more money on the line. So obviously at the end of the day, I want to race well and just perform. So that's my main focus. And I try not to necessarily think about money parts, you know, you race well, you get paid more. So that's just kind of how it goes. But I think it's cool. It's fun that we're doing the playoffs and it's new for everyone. So it'll be fun to see how it shapes up. But I think it should be pretty good.
Awesome. Good luck.
Thank you. I appreciate it.